Welcome back to another episode of GSD Talks, and we're going to do a little change this time. This is actually going to be, as Brittany will tell you, a bit of GSD Talks and also GSD Fails. The topics have changed a little bit on this one too, and very excited today to have Brittany join me, who will do an intro of what we're going to talk about. But I think when you see the topic, you don't see a lot of this actually within our industry discussed. So very topical, exciting, and actually, I think, extremely value add. So Brittany, thanks very much for taking the time to join. And why don't you tell us about what we're going to talk about?
Thanks, Lee. We have Brian Smith on the line. He's a partner at Deloitte, but also a industry veteran in digital technologies and transformation, and a good friend of mine. So I thought, since I've followed him throughout my career, but also poked and prodded him throughout my career about what to say and what not to say, that we could do a little mini GSD Talks and GSD Fails about a young person or somebody entering the industry in 2020, after the pandemic, coming into, regardless of which industry you're coming into, what to say and what not to say when you're talking to either a potential employer or your current existing employer. So with that, Brian, do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, perfect. First of all, thanks for having me, Brittany. It's great, great to see you again. I wish I could be in warm, sunny Florida to see you in person, but it's great to join. So yeah, just by way of quick intro, Brian Smith, I'm a partner at Deloitte Consulting. I sit inside of Deloitte Digital. I focus on technology strategy work, technology implementation work, specifically in and around sales, service, and marketing. I also lead our U.S. customer operations practice. So in terms of, I think, this topic, I've got a good amount of experience, both in terms of having negotiated salaries throughout my time, but also do quite a bit of hiring. So see it from the other side of the table as well.
Good. And like I said, I've poked you many times about how to go about things, because I know what you did in your career was you basically jumped and catapulted your career at such a quick rate, at such a young age, that I think you did it right. So let's get to it. So if I were a young person entering an industry in 2020, right now, let's say in September, what do you think the best way to negotiate a salary would be if you thought it came in low?
I think, Brittany, where I would actually probably start, and I think this is whether or not it's 2020 kind of COVID situation or just any time, I would actually start by saying, first get perspective on what it is you're negotiating. So first and foremost, are you negotiating the job first and then negotiate the salary? So don't lose perspective that of what's most important to you. And is getting the job most important, or is getting the job plus another 3,000 annually matter? So right. I think the first thing I would tell anyone is just have that perspective. And if it comes down to money and you're just talking about money, that's probably a different conversation. And your first paycheck may prove you wrong as to how much value an extra $3,000 or $5,000 is in the long run. So first and foremost, just have a perspective of that and don't lose perspective. This is about getting a job and hopefully one that you care to have. That would be kind of part one, Brittany. And I think part two is don't lose perspective about or underestimate what a certain job offers outside of just what you typically think about negotiating, which is a salary or a bonus. But think about now, especially now, think about what else that might offer you. What does that offer you and your brand to get a job with a certain company, depending on what your goals and aspirations are?
Right.
What is, you know, like some people are trying to break into new industries like AWS or used to be Salesforce. Like I have an example of, I was kind of pivoting at one point in my life 10 years ago from doing certain kind of work. And I really wanted to get into Salesforce work. And I had an opportunity to go join Salesforce and take a job with them. And as I was going through the negotiation, frankly, the exact job I got felt a little bit siloed, like it was a services leader job in a given area, like a region. And I've never really worked regionally before. And that wasn't terribly exciting at the time, but it offered me the opportunity to break into an area that mattered. And frankly, I wouldn't have the job that I have today if I wouldn't have taken that job at Salesforce to step into what I now do. So don't lose track of that. And I would add to that is, like, think about things now, like having the ability to, now we all work from home kind of for now, but what opportunities do you have to travel? I love to travel. So being a consultant for me, having the opportunity to work with clients and for instance, have business expenses that allow me to travel and do the things that I want to do. That's a huge
travel
benefit.
Budget. Right.
So negotiating $5,000 in salary might not matter. So think about all things, all the perks. So don't lose sight of, and don't negotiate to negotiate, right?
Oh, I like that. Don't negotiate to negotiate. So that's the other question is, like, let's say an offer came in and it was good. I've done this before and I actually thought it was a good way to do it, but an offer that I didn't expect came in higher than I anticipated. And I was like, oh my God, should I wait a day to accept? Or do you just accept because you're like, this is what I want. This is what I want. Is there like a waiting game you should do with these employers, or is it, if it's right, it's right. Do it, push the go button. Like, what are your perspective on?
Yeah, I think it's very personal, would be first and foremost. And I would say going into it, this is maybe obvious, but maybe not, is you should always have an understanding of your value. So understand the business that you're talking to, understand how their company operates, understand how their company makes money. And understand what your role is in that company and how will you be accretive to having them make money, and then understand the potential value that that role brings. And you should probably have some idea of what the market pays for that. And if you go in and you get a job, you interview and you get a job offer, again, I don't think you have to negotiate to negotiate. If you feel that's the right value, take it and move on. And I would tell you from the other side of the table, one of the things I like the most when I'm talking to a candidate is, like, I wouldn't underestimate how much likability, as well as when someone is like all in, even if they want to negotiate with me a little bit on money or maybe not, me realizing and feeling the sense that somebody wants that job and they want it and they see the trajectory, like then it's a human conversation and negotiation is a different thing.
That's interesting from that perspective, because it's true, right? You can feel it on the other side, I'm sure, what the candidate's feeling on this side. So if it's right, go for it, basically.
That's right. I think so. I mean, again, it's all personal. And I've done this, like, in terms of you're calling this kind of the fails. I mean, if I think about areas in which I have failed earlier in my career, I was very attracted to and felt like I was chasing titles. I was chasing the next, you know, what's the bonus? I was chasing those things. And I realized quickly that that wasn't what necessarily made me happy. So having a job with a title, you know, and maybe money that I thought was right, but I wasn't excited about it. You know, once you're in that job for 3 months, the title wears off and you realize the pay isn't what kind of motivates you to wake up. So think about like these are the things that I think, you know, young people, I would, you know, passion matters. So your ability to enjoy it, work around, like, and make sure when you're interviewing, like, it's just as much as an interview for you back to the company as the company to you. So truly understand what's the environment like, who are you working with? What is your boss like? And those relationships, you know, dig into that.
And somebody smart told me too, like, your job really is to make your bosses look good and also take more of their responsibility on so that they don't have to do your job and their job.
I think that's right. And so that's a good point around, I also think when you're negotiating for a job or a salary, don't lose track of, you know, this is all human engagement. So you're negotiating from your human standpoint. That is a human that you're talking to. It's not just a company.
Robot.
Understand what they care about. If you're talking to, perhaps it's your would-be boss, what matters to them? When they're asking you questions, don't think about what is the answer to the question. Think about what was their intent in asking you that question, and so why are they asking you that question?
So what's an example of that? So like if you're sitting in front of me and I'm, what would you say? What were the words that you would say out loud?
People love to talk about behavioral questions in interviews. So tell me about a time when you have done the following.
Challenge.
Whatever the question is, what I would be thinking about is understanding who am I speaking to? What is their responsibilities? What is their responsibilities in turn in connection to the job I'm interviewing for? And start to think about, if they're asking me this question, they're probably asking it because they care of the connection point to this job. So again, think about the intent of the question they're asking and not necessarily the question. That'll help you start to shape, how does this person think about whoever's going to step into this role? And you'll start to understand, like, that negotiation changes that, and your understanding of the job changes. And the point of where I'm going with this is, every one of those conversations is different. If you're talking to the hiring manager versus you may be talking to HR, and how you negotiate are very different things. If you're negotiating with HR, again, if you're doing what I suggested and you're thinking about, what does this person care about? The HR person is incentivized, is thinking differently than the hiring manager. The hiring manager probably has some problem, and they're looking to you to help solve that problem. So you're selling on your value to solve that problem. At HR, hopefully by that time, you are either early in the stages and trying to get to the manager, or you're in late stage negotiation. You perhaps have already proven your value. And with HR, it's a negotiation with the company. And at that point, it's probably salary bands and things like that. So again, understand the perspective and who you're talking to and how that dialogue goes.
That is a really, really great point. I didn't think of that, because it is true. There are multiple levels of negotiation. Sometimes you're dealing with the manager themselves and sometimes you're not. That brings up my next point. What would you not say when you're negotiating a salary or even a package? Let's say I really wanted to work from home, but this job isn't a work from home job. How would you not go about it? Like, what would be the wrong things? Do you have any examples by chance of like things you've been through?
The first thing that comes to mind would be, I would stay away from any ultimatums. So I know that's not specifically what I wouldn't do, but like, I think anytime you get to a place where you're throwing out any ultimatum, just avoid it, unless it's absolutely something that you're gonna stick to and call a bluff on. Ultimatums tend, in my opinion, if I'm on the other side and someone's telling me I'm either taking this job or not because of this, I'm a bit turned off, because I now realize their focus isn't probably aligned to my focus. I mean, I appreciate transparency, but I don't want the ultimatum, right? Like, help me understand more. Go ahead.
No, you said it earlier, is that if they're you can tell if they're invested in this job and what this job is about.
Yeah. Yeah. So I would say two things. I'm thinking about your question. So two things would be, one, and I'm flipping it a little bit. One is, be transparent. I don't buy in salary negotiation. I don't buy into the adage that if you read a negotiation book, you generally say the person that speaks first or throws a number out first loses. I'm actually not sure that that's the case in job negotiation. Be transparent in what you want. If you've come in prepared, if we've talked about, you know your value, you know the job, you know the range, you know what you want, say it, right? Because if you don't, and the company's going to tell you, like, they probably have a range, but if the company's going to tell you, they're going to come in on the lower edge, I believe, right? So say what you want and get it out there and start the conversation. I believe in that transparency. So I guess my point would be, maybe not being transparent would be something I wouldn't do. So I would be transparent.
Right. Be transparent early.
Yeah. What do you want? Like, go after it, right? You don't get, and I get this every so often with folks is, well, I did a bad job of negotiating when I joined, and I just, you know, kind of thought that this would come along. It's like when you form a relationship and you form it based off some assumption you have that you didn't fully communicate. The other person's like, wait, that doesn't seem fair. So don't get yourself in that trap.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So that brings us to our next one, Brian. So when is a good time to ask a manager or even, you know, somebody that is in a position to give me it's time for a promotion. You know, how should I go about it? How do I get my manager's attention that says, hey, you know, I've proven myself and here's why I think I've proven myself. When should I do that? When's the right time? When's the wrong time?
Yeah, I think there's a delicate balance there, because there's the balance of folks that are kind of constantly squeaky and you realize, like, is this person focused on the job they're doing today, or are they just focused on the next thing? So I guess what I would say is, first of all, focus on doing your job and doing what you said you would do, and do it, do it excellently. That's one. And once you know you're doing that, and once you get to the point where you realize I'm already operating at the next level, or I am operating to a point where I deserve more compensation, you can have that conversation, but I would say don't have it in the construct of I want more money. Have it in a construct of this is what I'm being asked to do. This is what I'm doing, and this is how I'm excelling at it. And oh, by the way, by me excelling at my job, this is how I've contributed to the company, right? And I've created more value. So have it under the construct of business impact, business value, and not your own, right? So speak away from yourself. And then it's the opportunity to say, how do you think I'm doing? Am I, you know, based on our conversations, it's kind of fact-based. Like you expected me to do this. It's black and white. I'm doing these things. I've gone so far as to, to kind of quantify those things.
Right.
And then come and say, like, my understanding, like, I think I can do more and I can do more better. I'd like to understand by doing more is, you know, does that make sense for us to talk about either a promotion? Sometimes it's cut and dry. You know that there's a next level. It gets easy to have that debate. Sometimes it's more ambiguous. But by having that in terms of the company, your contributions, how those contributions contribute large amounts of potentially money or savings back to a company, makes it much easier for you to ask for a promotion or a raise. And by the way, I think you can do it at any time. And if you happen to be employed by a company that has very formal performance management structure, then that's even better, because you can kind of be ahead of that game. And if you know
when that conversation's going to happen, and you can build up your performance to show that at that time.
And be ahead of it, right? Be ahead of it. There's a lot of, like, there is something to be said for people that are vocal about it. And again, that balance, vocal to the point of, I've kept you up to speed, right? We started out the year, I set goals, I said I was going to do this. I've kind of kept you up to speed along the way. Forget about performance management systems, right? But I have done my best to keep you up to speed. You've acknowledged along the way that I'm coming, like your head nodding the whole way. Now, here we are at mid-year, or here we are at the end of the year. You continue to head nod. It makes it easy, right? It's the no-brainer promotion, no-brainer raise.
Right. And what's the question? Like, my question back to you is, like, what do we do? I think that 2020 added a wrench in the whole thing, because if you think about it too, like, a lot of people are expected probably a promotion this year if the world was normal, right? Yeah. The world's not normal anymore. Budgets are getting cut everywhere. Now we're probably going back to the point where we're thankful for our jobs, right? So at that point, it's just patience, I would assume, right? We should just have patience, or what do you think?
Well, I mean, I think everybody in every scenario is different. You know, some organizations are are having a really tough time with COVID and the situation. So I really do think it's based on your situation. But I would say, as though, again, you can't control everything. You can't control the macroeconomic situation. Sometimes you can't control the position a company is in. You can control your production, right?
Right.
And so focus on your value and your production, and focus on having those conversations, being very specific. Like, I want to have a conversation about my future. My comments around words are, I just don't think you want to lead with, I need more money, I want more money, how do I get more money, how do I get a promotion? It is, I'd like to talk about my career. I'd like to talk about the next steps in my career. I'd like to talk about, what does that mean in terms of the next step in terms of a compensation? What does that mean in terms of next step for my role, my responsibilities? So speak in terms of the company and not yourself, though it's an obvious connection. I can't speak to every company's ability to promote someone, or everybody's every company's ability to pay more, because that just isn't the reality. But you can control yourself and focus on that, and good things will come.
Well done. That's a wrap.
Awesome questions. No, that was fun. Thanks for having me.